Thanks a lot, Megan. Brandon police are investigating the first homicide in that city in more than 2 years. It happened Saturday night on Red Oak Drive in Brandon. Police charged 47-year-old Robert McGuire with the murder of his living girlfriend, Linda Tate. 16 WAPT's Aaron Kelly joins us in the studio with the very latest on this investigation. Aaron.
Scott, the chief thought it had been longer, but there was a murder case that fell inside the city limits about 2 years ago. This case fell at a neighbor's doorstep when he says Robert McGuire came to his home and told him he murdered his girlfriend.
John Santa Stephen was sitting at home Saturday night when he heard a knock at his door.
Opened the door and he says, "You need to call the cops, I just killed my girlfriend." And he walked away and I just said, "Right." I didn't believe him.
Santa Stephen called Brandon police, who charged his 47-year-old neighbor Robert McGuire with the murder of live-in girlfriend 61-year-old Linda Tate. Police say McGuire shot her once in the head at this home on Red Oak Drive, but it's not clear why.
Mr. McGuire was upset about something, but I don't know, as to the motive, what transpired prior to this, I don't know.
Santa Stephen describes McGuire as moody and a mean drunk, but says the couple didn't appear to have serious problems.
Sometimes you can hear them arguing outside, but nothing real violent that you could say that was violent.
Police say they have no reports of any calls to the home prior to the shooting. Tate's death marks the first homicide in the city in more than 2 years.
I wish it didn't happen, but it did. But, Brandon's a good city to live in, a safe city to live in. It's just one of these things that, you know, occasionally bad things happen.
Santa Stephen says he knows the neighborhood is safe, but he's still trying to get over what police say happened next door.
Just kind of weird because nothing ever happened like that around here. I've been here 18 years and never had anything like that happen.
Now, McGuire is being held at the Rankin County Jail. His initial appearance is expected Monday or Wednesday. Scott?
Thanks a lot, Aaron.